उत्तिष्ठ जाग्रत प्राप्य वरान् निबोधत क्षुरस्य धारा निशिता दुरत्ययः दुर्गं पतस्तत् कवयो वदन्ति. उत्तिष्ठत गेट अप, जाग्रत वेक अप, प्राप्य वरान् निबोधत गो टू ए रियलाइज्ड मास्टर. वरान् मीन्स् वन हू इज सुप्रीम. निबोधत मीन्स टीचर. गो टू ए सुप्रीम टीचर. क्षुरस्य धारया धारा निशिता दुरत्यया द पाथ ऑफ सेल्फ रियलाइजेशन इज लाइक वॉकिंग ऑन ए रेजर्स एज इज शार्प. ओके, वॉकिंग ऑन ए रेजर्स एज. सो ही इज गिविंग ए कॉल. उत्तिष्ठता गेट अप, wake up, you are dreaming now, you are in sleep. Jagrata, wake up. Prapya vara nibodhata, go to a enlightened master, a supreme teacher. Kshurasya dhara nishita duratyaya, the journey of spirituality is like walking on a razor's edge. Durgam is difficult. So say the jnanis who are enlightened, they say it is difficult. Okay. Durgam patastat, the path of self-realization is difficult. So say the knowers of the truth, jnanis. Okay. So this particular sentence, Vivekananda gave a call for the nation. Arise, awake, stop, do not stop until the goal is reached. This is the call of Vivekananda, Swami Vivekananda. Arise, awake, stop not till the goal is reached. That's exactly taken from the Kathopanishad. Okay? So, Uttishtata. Get up, jagrata, wake up. Now you are dreaming, your dream called Maya. And in that dream, the world is appearing. World is nothing but name and forms. Name and form has no reality without the consciousness. Okay? You are actually forgotten yourself, which is consciousness. You are giving reality to the world of name and form. Alright? Wake up. So this is almost saying you have gone for a 3D movie or 4D movie. Now there's a 5D movies also. Where everything appears so real. In a 5D movie, the chair also moves. If you sit in a chair, 5D movie, you feel as if you are falling from a mountain and water appears real. There's a sprinkling of water, everything appears real. And you may get scared. So there is no reality like that. It's an appearance. The world is an appearance of consciousness, it has no reality. You get up, wake up, and realize that the consciousness alone is the reality, sole reality. The gold ornaments are name and shapes. For the gold only. So the entire universe is made up of a stuff called consciousness. The matter is not real. Matter is unreal. Prapya varan nibodataha. This you can realize only when you go to a realized master. Varan. Varan means supreme. Okay. Because somebody who takes the world as real, or he himself is maya, he cannot show you the way. Somebody should be out of the Maya illusion. He only can show you the way. Kshurasya dhara. So the journey is like a razor's edge. Journey walking on a razor's edge. Right? Why is razor's edge? What is razor's edge is very sharp. You can fall off. In spiritual journey, the intellect has to be very, very sharpened. Subtle intellect has to be very sharpened through the knowledge which is obtained from Vedanta. It's called Viveka and Vairagya. Discrimination has to be sharp. If you don't discriminate properly, you can take up, you can have a wrong understanding of spiritual teachings. A wrong understanding will not lead you to anywhere. It leads to you fall. And this understanding has to be sharpened through Viveka. Sharpened intellect is called Viveka, and it can be sharpened only through Shravana, listening, Manana, Nididhyasa, contemplation. It requires a very, very sharp and subtle intellect to grasp the spiritual truths. A gross intellect cannot grasp. Okay? So there is a, there was two disciples of great teacher, Brihaspati Acharya. You can have a very great teacher called Brihaspati Acharya. There are two disciples. One is called Devendra, king of gods. And other is called Asurendra, or king of demons. So both of them go to Brihaspati Acharya to learn the self-knowledge, the science of immortality, the knowledge of immortal life. So to learn about the self, your mind has to become settled, mind has to calm down. So Devendra was very haughty that I am the king of gods, and Asurendra was haughty that he is king of demons. So then first they have to become humble. Okay, the knowledge cannot be obtained by who is haughty. So Brihaspati tells them, take care of my cow shed. Do service in my cow shed. For 12 years they do this service. After 12 years they come back and humbly ask Brihaspati Acharya, the master, please tell me the secret of immortality, the secret of deathlessness. Then Brihaspati Acharya takes them to a lake and shows them, see the reflection there. One who sees the reflection is real you. And that is Atma, the self. The self is birthless, deathless, immortal, ageless. Self is bliss, and you are that self, he tells. The king of demons sees the reflection. He sees his body. Oh, he thinks that body is the self. Okay. Then he goes back to, he says, he bows down to Acharya, Brihaspati Acharya, and goes back. Very happy. He has understood the secret of immortality. And he goes and tells all the demons. Okay. The body is the self. So decorate the body. Okay. Take care of body very well. Enjoy when you are alive. So this is the secret I learned from a master, Brihaspati Acharya. So then all the demons enjoy thinking that I am the body. And they have a philosophy called Charvaka. Philosophy of Charvaka. So that means the Charvaka philosophy is body is the sole reality. I am the body. Enjoy. Actually, that is the most popular philosophy in the world, followed by 99.9% of the people. I am the body. It became a very popular philosophy called Charvaka philosophy. So Devendra, king of gods, he looks at the body, and what is this my guru is telling? The body is becoming old. Body dies. How I can be immortal? This question, he has a question. He again asks Brihaspati Acharya, please tell me. Then Brihaspati Acharya says, okay, go, and because you are not understood. So do another 12 years of service. So like that, Brihaspati Acharya spends 96 years of his life. Devendra spends 96 years of life doing service with Brihaspati Acharya. Then Brihaspati Acharya gives the same example, takes him to the lake and shows him. The one who sees this reflection is you. Okay, then Devendra realizes the body is not the seer. Body is the instrument which is through which seeing. Eyes do not see. Through eyes, the seeing is happening. Mind doesn't see. Through mind, seeing is happening. Intellect doesn't understand. Through intellect, understanding is happening. One who does this is consciousness, and I am that consciousness. This understanding comes to Devendra. Then he realizes, oh, I am the consciousness which is birthless and deathless, immortal. And he becomes very blissful and he goes. That's why it is said that devatas are amara. They are deathless. And he goes that teaches the philosophy to all other divine beings, devatas. The teaching is same. Okay? The understanding can vary. That's why it's a sharp intellect is required for understanding this teaching. A mind has to be calm and intellect has to be sharp. Otherwise, you can misunderstand. The teacher may be great. Brahaspati Acharya is the greatest teacher. But from the greatest teacher, two students are learned it in a very different way. Right? All the teaching is same, but interpretation happens based on your mind, your impressions, vasanas. Another story, same Devendra and Danavendra, Asurendra. There, while studying, Brahaspati Acharya gives them only one teaching, one word teaching, called Da. Okay, no two words, only Da. Da is the teaching. Okay? Da is the teaching. Brahaspati Acharya in his Gurukula, there are three students. One human being, one divine being, Devendra, and another is Asurendra. See, while teaching, Da. Brahaspati Acharya gives only one word teaching, one alphabet, Da. Okay? So then, these three beings, they understood the teaching in a very different way. The demons understood daya. We have to develop compassion because we are all very cruel. Daya. Da means daya. Okay? Human beings understood we are very selfish. Da means dana. Okay? Devatas, divine beings understood da means dama. Means we are very after sense or sense organs. Okay? Dance, singing and all. Dama means we have to control sense organs. Same one teaching of one alphabet, Da, can mean different things to different people. Okay? Depending on your mind, you can interpret the same thing in a different way. So the spiritual teaching has to be, the student has to be sharp enough to grasp the essential meaning of the teaching. Otherwise, he can misunderstand it. That's why it's difficult. It's not that it's simple. The truth is simple. But mind adds color to that. That's why it said, it say, travel on the eraser's edge. Okay? Not because it involves a lot of struggle, it because involves a lot of sincerity on your point. So you have to be very sincere and to seek the truth. Anything which is non-truth, you should be able to discard with the intellect which is sharpened. Otherwise, you'll fall off. There are many people you may come across, think that they are spiritually evolved, okay? They have realized the truth. Maybe they have realized the truth. Ultimately, we are not nobody to judge it. But as far as each of us are concerned, we have to be very focused on the truth. And that truth can be obtained only through sharpened intellect.